I'm excited about this one. It's funny because we both look forward to learning about everything,
yes.
But there are certain things that appeal a little more to you,
right?
Like little bits, which I thought was neat. Then there are certain things that appeal more to me, like our next guest.
That's not to say that I'm not interested either.
No, it is not. It is not. Mark is here. Thanks
Hi,
for
Mark.
Joining us, Mark.
Yes,
you're with
welcome.
Mobile. You're with
Mobile Enhancement Specialist.
Yes.
It's a bit of a mouthful.
Yes.
We actually market the product more than our company name.
Right.
And
the product is?
This is a Bluetooth passive keyless entry system for your car. Very, very short version is it's going to turn your cell phone into the key fob for your car. So you walk up to the car, it's going to unlock. When you walk away from the car, it's going to lock for you.
We actually just did a little blog post about this one.
Yeah, we did.
On GeekBeat TV. You know, go to the website, guys.
It's geekbeat.tv/Bluetooth keyless.
There you go. But I'm very interested in the applications for this device because... you said that you could basically add it to any car, right?
Sure. It's the module itself. I don't know which way
we'll use the super close-up cam.
The module itself is entirely universal. We have analog outputs on it. And what that lets us do is it makes it universal for any car. Some cars might need a few extra parts. Really new cars need extra parts. Really old cars need extra parts.
Okay.
But it allows us to make it completely universal. And then... We do recommend to have it installed. This is not designed to be a do-it-yourselfer.
Yeah.
Okay,
so the retail businesses that handle our modules also handle the installation.
So when you say retail businesses, are we talking about like specialty audio kind of car?
Correct,
companies?
Yeah. Usually automotive specialists is primarily who installs this for us.
Okay.
Some new car dealers also have companies that come in and handle the product for them. But
so I have a 2005 car.
Mm-hmm.
It does not have much tech. I know, it's hard to believe, guys. It doesn't have much technology built in. It's like the bad thing about my life. But I have a friend who has, basically she has the key fob.
Like a smart key, right?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So I'm always jealous of that.
Sure.
So this would enable me to basically install that. And
not only would you be able to mimic it, but then your friend would be jealous of you because you would be using your cell phone.
Right. So I wouldn't even have to have a fob.
Right.
Let's talk about how it gets installed. So first of all, can I assume that your car needs to have power locks?
Yeah. If your vehicle does not have power locks on it.
You'd have to add them.
They can be added.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's why if you have a vehicle that's a little bit older that doesn't have locks, they can be added to it.
Okay.
Basically, any vehicle in the last 15 years or so is probably going to have power locks on it, most of them. Generally, we interface with the factory alarm, and that gives us our power locks, also some other convenience features as well, like turning on the dome light for you, things like that. Uh-huh. So there is a little bit of variance depending on the car.
Okay.
And we have two different versions. We have a standard version, which we released in December. And that is universal with any cell phone that has Bluetooth.
Okay.
So if your phone has Bluetooth,
Android,
across the board.
Anything.
It doesn't matter.
Right.
BlackBerry, everything with
Correct.
Bluetooth. Okay.
Because it uses the Bluetooth menu that's built into the phone.
Okay.
The limitation to that is it works with one phone.
Oh, okay.
So
you have to pair one phone with one
car.
So
that's the limitation of the standard module.
Okay.
The premium version, which is what we're showing here today, comes with a companion app, and it's platform specific. So we'll have an app for iOS, one for Android, probably BlackBerry eventually.
Yeah.
And if you don't mind, I'm going to show you really quick.
Yeah, let's see.
I don't know what can get picked up on the camera.
We can get the whole thing. Hang on just a sec.
So let me know where you want it there.
There you go.
Okay. The biggest feature of the companion app is you have adjustable range. So you can adjust the unlock range and the lock range right from the cell phone.
Okay.
This is just a settings app. It doesn't have to be open. So you just make your settings to it and it runs in the background. So the process is still entirely automatic. You just walk up to the car. But because it has an app, it allows us to do multiple phones to one module. And we also included manual control too.
Oh, so that way you can just hit it.
Correct.
So I would have to have Bluetooth active at all times, correct?
You do need to have Bluetooth enabled on the cell phone.
Yeah, okay.
But as long as I've got Bluetooth on my cell phone, if she and I come out of Walmart together and we're walking through the park,
because
Walmart's awesome. That's where I got my little Hisense tablet, which I'm digging to. We come out of Walmart together, or where would you rather come out of?
Fries.
We come out of Fries together.
Okay.
And we're walking towards the car. It senses my phone, and does it just automatically unlock my doors?
Yeah, the way the premium version with the adjustable range, the way that works is it's going to determine how far away you are, and then based on how you have your settings.
Like within 10 feet.
Right, yeah.
Then it unlocks it.
Correct.
When I'm within 10 feet.
What's that?
When I'm within 10 feet, because I'm the one with the phone.
Correct.
So if she runs ahead of me, she can't get in the car. But
yeah,
if
she happens to sprint in front of you, then she's going to have to wait a few seconds.
She's fast. She's speedy, too. But
but okay, so what if your phone was lost? What do you do?
Use your key?
Right.
I mean, in terms of, like, deactivating
Right.
Well, this only gets you in the car. It doesn't start the car,
correct.
Right?
So.
Okay. There you go.
Yeah, there is. There are other companies that we're working with that offer a keyless ignition system that we may include ours in addition to that. And they have their own built-in backup safeties. But we're focusing strictly on keyless entry. That's really our goal. Yeah.
If I break my phone and I'm locked my car, I could still use my normal car remote or my key or whatever.
All your transmitters work the same. As far as the car is concerned, this is just an extra transmitter.
Okay, I was going to ask, let's say, for example, I have a pickup truck and there's a rear lift gate.
Mm-hmm.
Could you automatically trigger that to lock and unlock? But I guess anything that has a lock, you can
trigger
it. Sure,
a lot of newer cars, they'll include the trunk lock with the door locks now.
Right.
So when you walk up to the car, it's going to do the door locks. It's also going to do the trunk for you, too. Anything that can be connected to the factory door lock system, we can control.
And so you said the new system is the pro version? Is that what you called it?
Yeah, we have the premium version.
The premium version.
Mm-hmm.
How much is the premium version? Because I don't want the one that will only do one key. I want it to do as many as I want.
Well, just to be fair to other people.
how much are both? Okay.
The standard version, which is currently available, is $149 plus installation.
Okay.
Installation is going to vary on your vehicle.
What do you think the installation is average?
The average price for the standard is right around $250 to $300, depending on your area. Labor rates vary a little bit.
But you're maybe looking around $400 to get Bluetooth unlocking.
No, total. No, the standard version, for most vehicles, $300 installed.
Oh, okay. All right.
So you'll have $150 for the module, and then parts and labors is going to be $1 to $150.
Okay.
And the premium version is $189.
Oh, it's only 30 bucks more. 40 bucks more.
40 bucks more. Exactly. So most 90% of the people are going to choose the premium version.
Yeah.
So Public Glutton in the chat room would like to know. He says, I know this is not a question, but how about aircraft?
Aircraft?
Could this work?
Do airplanes have door locks? I don't know.
I don't know.
I've never seen anybody unlock the door to their. I don't know. I guess they do.
We do offer a lot of custom applications for motorcycles and things, but no one's asked for an airplane before. So.
Well, here's your first.
Yeah. We'll have to look into it and see.
I wonder if the FAA would have regulations about adding this. But if it's just a door lock, you would think that wouldn't. But who knows?
If
it's attached to a plane, the FAA probably has something.
If it's electronic, we can probably talk to it. We'll have to double check on the airplanes. I don't know off the top of my head.
Fair enough.
Good question.
Well, thank you so much for coming us the Bluetooth keyless, Bluetooth passive keyless entry, right?
And people can find more about it where?
Bluetoothkeyless.info.
Awesome. Okay.
All right.
And all their custom high-end retailers of automotive.
Yeah, any local automotive specialist is going to have information.
Okay.
Awesome.
Perfect.
All right. Thank you very much,
guys.
Thank you. Have a great show.
You too.